This video tutorial, I will explain how to install RabbitMQ in Linux operating system or Amazon EC2 instance. Here you can see Amazon AWS console, and here I have started the EC2 instance. It is running. Copy this public IPv4 address to log into the Amazon EC2 instance. And I have logged in into the Amazon EC2 instance. The first step is we have to install EPEL release. And once you install only, we can install RabbitMQ server and its dependency Erlang. EPEL is nothing but extra packages for enterprise Linux. And once you install, we can install RabbitMQ server and Erlang dependency. To install EPEL release, we have to use this command: sudo minstall EPEL release. Click on enter. And here you can see it is showing the summary. It is going to install EPEL release. And if you want to proceed, you can type Y, else you can type N. I am typing N. I didn't install. Suppose this sudo minstall EPEL release command is not working, we can use this command: sudo Amazon Linux extras install EPEL. Click on enter. And here you can see it is showing the summary. It is going to install EPEL release. Now this time I am typing Y so that it will install, and EPEL release is successfully installed. Next, I am going to install Erlang dependency. We have to use this command. Type Y, and it is installed successfully. Next, I am going to install RabbitMQ server, and we have to use this command. And it is successfully installed. Using this command, we can list out all the RabbitMQ plugins. And here you can see the list of plugins. In that, we have to enable RabbitMQ management so that we can open RabbitMQ management UI. We will see how to do that. Use this command to enable RabbitMQ management. And it has been enabled. To check that, again run the list command, and here you can see RabbitMQ management is enabled. You can see E here. Next, using this systemctl enable command, enable the RabbitMQ server. Enter. Using sudo systemctl start RabbitMQ server command, the RabbitMQ server has been started successfully. To open RabbitMQ management UI, we have to use this URL. Port number is 15672. And the DNS name, we have to use the current DNS name. Here you can see public IPv4 DNS name. Copy this URL . Click on enter, and it is not working. because this 15672 port is not public. We have to do some configuration change in EC2 instance. We will do that, then check this URL, it will work. Here click on security, click on this. Click on Edit Inbound Rules. Click on Add Rule. Custom TCP. Then the port number. Select Anywhere IPv4. Save Rules. And it is successfully updated. Now click on refresh. Now you can see the RabbitMQ management UI is working. And it is asking username and password. Default username password is guest. And I have logged in successfully. RabbitMQ version is 3.3.5. We have successfully installed RabbitMQ and we have successfully logged into the RabbitMQ management UI. Suppose you want to stop the RabbitMQ server, use this command: sudo systemctl stop RabbitMQ server. And it is stopped successfully. We can check that. Refresh. And it is stopped. And to start again, use systemctl start RabbitMQ server. And it has been started. To check where RabbitMQ is installed and where RabbitMQ related directories are there, use this command: where is RabbitMQ? And it is there inside userlib and etc folder. We will check userlib. RabbitMQ related log files will be there inside VAR folder. And here you can see RabbitMQ, click on this. And permission is not there to see the log. We will apply the permission, then we will check. For EC2 user, I am giving permission for this log folder using this command, and permission has been given. Now you can see the log file. Open this. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more. And here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.